This lesson focuses on using a type of audio filter called RTAS, which stands for Real-Time Audio Suite. Each audio track in Media Composer has a solo button and a mute button. If you click the solo button on track A1, you will not hear any of the other tracks when you play the sequence. Now, if you listen carefully, there is a low-frequency hum in the audio for this segment.
We had a call from fire rescue that there were three men being extricated from a manhole, and all three of them were unconscious and not breathing.
You can fix this by applying an audio filter to the track. Navigate to the project window and click on the purple effects icon tab. Towards the bottom of the list, you will see a list of RTAS categories. Click on the mono EQ category. Look for the EQ3 one band filter, and then drag it onto the A1 track. A dialog box will appear asking you to insert the filter into one of five available banks. So go ahead and select a bank. In the upper left corner of the timeline window, click on this slide arrow to reveal the track control panel. The track control panel provides access to the five audio filter banks for each track. There are also three buttons at the top that also affect each individual track. The waveform icon will turn on the audio waveform specific to this track. This is important because if you have a very long sequence, it can take a while to draw the waveform for all your tracks. Next, the audio display button will turn on the various volume display options for the specific track. And this button here will deactivate the entire track, which means in addition to the track being muted, you will not be able to make level adjustments using the audio mixer tool. Within the track control panel area, click on the bank that contains the RTAS filter. This will launch a dialog box for the filter that you've applied. This particular EQ filter allows you to create a graph in order to increase or decrease a specific audio frequency. By pulling down an area of the graph, it will remove a specific audio frequency. Now, the great thing about using an RTAS filter is that you can play the sequence and make and hear adjustments in real time. I found it's best to play a loop of a specific area while you make adjustments. To do this, you can press the Mark Clip button to mark in and out points for a segment area. Then, hold down the Alt key on the keyboard and press the number 6. This will loop the marked area.
We had a call from fire rescue.
So now, I'll slide the graph until the hum starts to go away.
And all three of them were unconscious and not breathing.
You can also narrow the range of the graph by adjusting the Q knob.
Being extricated from a manhole, and all three of them were unconscious and not breathing.
Okay, that sounds a lot better. Now, keep in mind that when using an RTAS filter, any adjustments are applied to the entire track. You may encounter a situation where you need to use an RTAS filter for a specific segment. If this happens, do the following. Hold down the Alt key and right-click in the gray area of the timeline window. Choose New Audio Track Mono. Specify a track just below the track you are working on. Another dialog box may appear telling you this track already exists. If so, press the Insert button. Use the Red Segment Smart tool to move the segment down onto its own track. Then, drag the RTAS filter from the previous track into the bank for the new track. Okay, fantastic. Now you have the basics of using an RTAS audio filter.
We had a call from fire rescue that there were three men being extricated from a manhole.